நவோஜன் சக்தி நேயர்களே வணக்கம். மற்ற நேயர்கள் தயவுசெய்து கீழே உள்ள சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பட்டனை அமுத்துங்க, பெல் ஐக்கானை அமுத்துங்க, உங்களுக்கு நிறையா வீடியோஸ் வரும். இந்த வீடியோவை கேளுங்க, நீங்கள் என்ன மனசில் நினச்சிங்களோ அதெல்லாம் நடக்கும். அட்லீஸ்ட் ஒரு 5 மினிட்ஸாவது கேளுங்க. சாய் சத் சரித்திரம் சாப்டர் 36, 2 ஜென்டில்மேன் அண்ட் மிஸ்ஸஸ் ஔராங்காபாத்கர். This chapter relates the wonderful stories of two gentlemen from Goa and Mrs. Aurangabadar of Cholapur. Two gentlemen. Once two gentlemen came from Goa for taking darshan of Sai Baba and prostrated themselves before him. Though both came together, Baba asked only one of them to give him rupees 15 as dakshana, which was paid willingly. The other man voluntarily offered rupees 35, which was rejected by Baba. To the astonishment of all, Shama, who was present, asked Baba, "What is this? Both came together, once dakshina you accept, the others though voluntarily paid you refuse." "Why this discrimination?" Baba replied, "Shama, you know nothing. I take nothing from anybody. The masjid moy, the presiding deity of the masjid, calls for the debt. The donor pays it and becomes free. Have I any home, property or family to look after? I require nothing. I am ever free debt, enmity and murder have to be atoned for, as there is no escape from them." Baba then contributed in his characteristics way as follows. At first he was poor and took a vow to his God that he would pay his first month's salary if he got a job. He got one for rupees 15 per month. Then he steadily got promotions. From rupees 15 he got rupees 30, 300, 200 and ultimately rupees 700 per month. But in his prosperity he forgot completely the vow he took. "The force of his karma has driven him here and I asked that amount of rupees 15 from him as dakshina." Another story. "While wandering by the seaside, I came to a huge mansion and sat in his venda. The Brahmin owner gave me a good reception and fed me sumptuously. He showed me a neat and calm place, clean place, near a cupboard for sleeping. I slept there. While I was sound asleep, the man removed a laterite slab and broke the wall, crept in and scissored off all the money from my pocket when I woke up. I found that rupees 30,000 were stolen. I was greatly distressed and sat weeping and mourning. The money was in currency notes and I thought that the Brahmin had stolen it. I lost all interest in food and drink and sat for a fortnight in the veranda, bemoaning my loss. After the fortnight was over, a passing fakir saw me crying and made inquiries regarding the cause of my sorrow. I told him everything. He said, if you act according to my bidding, you will recover your money. Go to a fakir. I shall give his whereabouts. Surrender yourself to him. He will get your money back. In the meanwhile, give up your favorite food till you recover your money." I followed the fakir's advice and got my money. Then I went to the seashore where a steamer was standing, but I could not get into it as it was overcrowded. There a good-natured peon integrated for me and I got in luckily. That brought me to another shore from where I caught a train and came to Masjid Moy. The story finished and Baba asked Shama to take the guests and arrange for their feeding. Then Shama took them home and fed them. At dinner, Shama said to the guests that Baba's story was rather mysterious as he had never gone to the seaside, never had any money, rupees 30,000, never travelled, never lost any money and never recovered it, and inquired from them whether they understood it and caught its significance. The guests were deeply moved and were shedding tears. In a choked voice, they said that Baba was omniscient, infinite, the supreme one, Parabrahma without a second. The story he gave out is exact our story. What he spoke has already taken place in our case. How he knew this is a wonder of wonders. We shall give all the details after the meals. Then after the meals, while they were chewing betel leaves, the guests began to tell their stories. One of them said, a hill station on the Ghats is my native place. I went to Goa to earn my living by securing a job. I took a vow to God that if I got a job, I would offer him my first month's salary. By his grace, I got a job of rupees 15. And then I got promotions as described by Baba. I did forget all about my vow. Baba has just reminded me of it in this way and recovered rupees 15 from me. It is not Dakshina, as one may think, is it to be, but a repayment of an old debt and fulfillment of long forgotten woe. Moral. In fact, Baba never begged for any money, nor allowed his bhaktis to beg. He regarded money as a danger or bar to spiritual progress and did not allow the bhaktas to fall into its clutches. Bhakta Magal Sapati is an instant on this point. He was very poor and could hardly make both ends meet. Baba never allowed him to make any money, nor gave him anything from the Dakshina collections. Once a kind and liberal merchant named Hansraj gave a large amount of money to Magal Sapati in Baba's presence, but Baba did not permit him to accept it. Then the second guest began his tale. My Brahmin cook was serving me faithfully for 35 years. Unfortunately, he fell into bad ways. His mind changed and he robbed me of my treasure by removing a laterite slab from my wall where my cupboard is fixed. He came in while we were all asleep and carried away all my accumulated wealth, rupees 30,000, in currency notes. I know not how Baba mentioned the exact amount. I sat crying day and night. My inquiries came to nothing. I spent a fortnight in great anxiety. As I sat on the veranda, sad and dejected, a passing fakir saw my condition and inquired of its cause. And I told him all about it. He told me that an Avaliya saint by name Sai lives in Shiradi, Kopargan Taluka, make vow to him and give up any food that you like best and say to him mentally that I have given up eating that food till I take your darshan. Then I took the vow and gave up eating rice and said, Baba, I will eat it after recovering my property and after taking your darshan, Baba Sairam. 15 days passed after this, the Brahmin of his own accord came to me, returned my money and apologized, saying, I went mad and acted thus. I now place my head on your feet. Please forgive me. Thus everything needed well, ended well. The fakir that met me and helped me was not seen again. An intense desire to see Sai Baba, whom the fakir pointed out to me, arose in my mind. I thought that the fakir who came all the way to my house was none other than Sai Baba. Could he? He saw me and helped me to get my last money. Ever cover rupees 35? Covered rupees 35? On the contrary, without expecting anything from us, he always lead us on the path of spiritual progress. I was enjoyed, overjoyed. When I recovered my stolen property and being ignorant, I forgot all about my woe. Then when I was at Colaba, one night I saw Sai Baba in my dream. This reminded me of my promised visit to Shirdi. I went to Goa and from there wanted to start for Shirdi by taking a steamer to Mumbai en route. But then when I came to the harbour, I found that the steamer was crowded and there was no place. The captain did not allow me, but one intercession of a peon who was a stranger to me, I was allowed to get into the steamer, which brought me to Mumbai. From there I came by train. Surely I think that Baba is all pervading and all knowing. What are we and where is our home? How fortunate we are that Baba got our money back and drew us here to himself. Shirdi folks must be infinitely superior and more fortunate than me, for Baba has played, laughed, talked and lived with you for so many years. I think that your store of good merits must be steamer and brought me here must be infinite. Sai is our Datta, Lord Dattatreya. He gave me a neat seat in the steamer and brought me here, and thus gave proof of his omniscience and omnipotence. Mrs. Aurangabadkar, a lady from Solapur, the wife of Sakaram Aurangabadkar, had no issue during the long period of 27 years. She had made a number of vows to gods and goddesses for an issue, but was not successful. She then became almost hopeless. To make a last attempt in this matter, she came to Shirdi with her stepson Vishwant and stayed there for 2 months serving Baba. Whenever she went to the masjid, she found Baba surrounded by devotees. She wanted to see Baba alone, fall at his feet and open her heart and pray for an issue. But she did not get any suitable opportunity. Ultimately, she requested Shama to intercede with Baba for her. When he was alone, Shama said to her that Baba's darbar was open. Still, he would try for her and that the Lord might bless her. He asked her to sit ready with a coconut and joss sticks in the open country yard at the time of Baba's meals, and that when he beckoned to her, she should come up. One day after dinner, when Shama was wiping Baba's wet hands with a towel, the latter pinched Shama's cheek. Shama, feigning anger, said, "Deva, is it proper for you to pinch me like this? We don't want such a mischievous god who pinches us thus. Are we your dependents? Is this the fruit of our intimacy?" Baba replied, "Oh Shama, during the 72 generations that you were with me, I never pinched you till now, and now you resent my touching you." Shama replied, "I want God who will always love us and give us now dishes to eat. We do not want any reward from you or heaven, etc. Let our faith and to your feet be ever awake." "Baba, yes, I have indeed come for that. I have been feeding and nursing you and have got love and affections for you." Then Baba went up and took his seat. Shama beckoned to the lady. She came up, bowed down and presented the coconut and joss stick. Baba shook the coconut, which was dry. The kernel within rolled and made noise. Baba said, "Shama, this is rolling. See what it says. Shama, the women prays that a child should similarly roll in her womb. So please give her the coconut with your blessing, Baba. Will the coconut give her any issue? How foolish people are, so fancy such things. Shama, I know the power of your words and blessings. Your word will give her a series of children. You are wrangling and not giving real blessing. The parley went on for a while. Baba repeatedly ordered to break the coconut and Shama pleaded for the gift of the entire fruit to the lady. Finally, Baba healed her and said she will have an issue. When? Asked Shama. In 12 months, was the reply. At this, the coconut was broken into two parts. One was eaten by the two, the other was given to that lady. Then Shama turned up to the lady and said, "Dear lady, you are a witness to my words. If within 12 months you do not get any issue, I will break a coconut against this deva's head and drive him out of this masjid. If I fail in this, I will not call myself Madhav. You will soon realize what I say." She delivered a son in year's time, and the son was brought to Baba in his 5th month. The couple, both husband and wife, prostrated themselves before Baba, and her grateful father, Mr. Aurangab Bhatkar, paid a sum of ₹500, which was spent in constructing shed for Baba's Aas Shyam Karna. Bow to Sri Sai, peace to be all. Sadguru Sainath Magaraj Ki Jai. மற்ற நேயர்களே, தயவுசெய்து சப்ஸ்கிரைப் பண்ணுங்கள். சப்ஸ்கிரைபுக்கு ஒரு காசும் கிடையாது. இந்த வீடியோவை நீங்கள் 5 நிமிஷமோ இல்லை ஃபுல் இதையும் கேட்டாலும் உங்களுக்கு நல்லது. நீங்கள் நினச்சது அத்தனையும் பாபா கொடுப்பார். இதில் வந்து பாபா எப்படி அந்த லேடிக்கு ஒரு குழந்தையை கொடுத்தாரோ, குழந்தை இல்லாதவர்கள் வேண்டிக் கொண்டால், மனதார வேண்டிக் கொண்டு தன் பாவங்கள் தீர வேண்டிக் கொண்டால் கண்டிப்பாக குழந்தை பிறக்கும் என்று பாபா இதில் சத்தியம் செய்துள்ளார். தயவுசெய்து சப்ஸ்கிரைப் செய்யுங்கள். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.